With Adventure Time, I think the thing that, I mean, there's so many things that go into why it's, you know, such a broad appeal. But for me, I think the art style, it's very colorful and very vibrant. It, you know, you just get drawn into the world. You want to go see every little bit of this amazing, magical world. And then the characters are just so, even though they're like kind of crazy and they do all these crazy things, ultimately they're all very relatable in a very real way. And they're going through things in a way that, you know, anybody would, even though they're going through things like fighting dragons and stuff or going to these mystical lands, they're still very real people and they're very relatable. And I think that's what people like about it the most, is they can really see themselves in a lot of these characters. You know, Finn is kind of like the little boy in all of us, you know, the boy and his dog who just loves going on adventures. You know, it's kind of an idealized version of what we all want to be in a lot of ways. There's a lot of favorite parts. It's hard. I mean, getting to do it is obviously the best part, because having a job is nice. But I think one of my favorite parts is the people that I work with. I get to work with some of the coolest, you know, voice actors in the business, and I've grown up listening to them before I even got into acting. And so getting to learn from those people and call them my peers and just hang out with them and get to know them has been just the coolest thing in the world. And whenever you have a show that blows up and it becomes so widespread and known, like Adventure Time, across the entire world, is always just insane. You know, you never expect that going in. That's, you hope that the shows you work on are successful, but when people really take to it and just make it their own like they have with Adventure Time, that's always super special.